We have this pink lady apple tree, and in summer it gets loaded with apples and they are so delicious that we really want to duplicate this tree so that we can enjoy more apples. So this is how it looks in spring. You know, it is new blossoms are coming, and if you look under the tree, there are a lot of small apple saplings growing, and so you have to wonder whether they came from seeds or they grew from root. And then we saw this one, or noticed this one, that it is growing from the roots of the tree. So that means that this is an exact replica of the apple tree if we could dig it up. So that's what we are planning to do this spring. So we are going to dig up a couple of these and plant them in planters, and let's see if they survive. So we have watered around these saplings so that, you know, it is easier to dig them up, but it still, because we haven't tilled this soil in a long time, it's really hard, but we're trying somehow to get these saplings out. So I think this one is loose now. It will come out. It is definitely attached to the root of the trunk, as you can see there, you know, that these are small roots, and that big line from the top left to top right is the root of the tree. Here, now it is out, and it has small roots. This is another one we are trying to take out. Here you can see the big root from where it is growing. So what we have to do is that we have to chip off the sapling from the root without cutting the root fully. We'll just take a portion out of the root. That way the root will also stay and the tree will not get disturbed too much, and the sapling will be out too. So we have cracked the roots, and now, you know, we can just take off. Here, look at this, you know, the whole woody root, you know, we have taken it out. So here is a planter in which we have a good potting soil mix, and we are going to put this small apple tree there. Press it gently so that the roots get the support. So the this apple sapling is a little big, so we have taken a big planter. It's about 12 inch in height and about 15 inches in width. So put the whole plant in with the mother root and just press gently so that it gets the support. Because both these saplings will get a shock because they were uprooted from the mother root. So we are going to put it in a humid and warm place so that they recuperate, and maybe in a week's time or 10 days we'll move it to a filtered light area. And now we're going to water it. So we have put these planters under the trees, and it has a lot of foliage around it, so it is humid and it is shaded, so they'll be fine here. And after a week or 10 days we'll move it to a slightly more lit area, depending on how they are doing.
So it's been about 6 months that we planted these two apple, we separated these two apple plants from a big apple tree. And so we had planted one in the middle that died, but then I planted one more here on the side and that survived. And similarly, this small one, this survived. So it has been growing very nicely. And now we can basically plant it in the ground. So the advantage of separating the plant from the tree like this is that it's a true copy of the tree. If you grow the plant from seeds, the apple plant from seeds, first of all, it will take a long time to bear fruit, and secondly, it will not be a true copy of the mother plant. But if you separate the plant like this or do air layering, then you know it is a true copy of the mother plant. So I hope this video was useful to you. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll try to answer as soon as possible. If you like this video, press the like button and subscribe to our channel. And I'll see you next time. Happy gardening. Bye.